फाइट ऑन रिजर्वेशन ऑफ म्युनिसिपल की इलेक्शन।
सुप्रीम कोर्ट टुडे हैज स्टेड द एंटायर हाई कोर्ट ऑर्डर एज ऑल्सो सुओमोटो स्टेड द ऑर्डर ऑफ द इलेक्शन कमीशन टू कीप द इलेक्शंस टू 5 म्युनिसिपल काउंसिल्स इन अबेयंस। एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ सुप्रीम कोर्ट स्टे ऑर्डर द इलेक्शन प्रोसेस हैज बीन रिस्टोर्ड बैक एंड द डेमोक्रेटिक प्रोसेस हैज अगेन स्टार्टेड। Matter has been now fixed for final hearing before the Supreme Court on Tuesday. In the meanwhile, the parties are directed to complete the pleadings. And we are very hopeful that we will succeed in this matter before the Supreme Court, because in our view, the High Court could not have interfered with the election process. The elections are the foundation of a democracy. This democracy rests on the election process, and it is all over the world a common thread in democracy that in election matters there is no interference whatsoever, because if there is interference in election matters by courts, then it is interference in the democracy. Democracy rests on the elected representatives of the people. For the smooth functioning of the democracy, the elected representatives should be put in their respective positions in time and at the earliest. So this principle has been evolved over a period of centuries, and our Supreme Court, in at least 2 constitutional bench judgments and 1 9-judge bench of the Supreme Court in SR Bommai case, has clearly said that a court shall not interfere with the election process, because this will go to interfere with the democracy directly. Thereafter, in Ashok Kumar's case, the Supreme Court has said the court can interfere if any defect in the election can be cured and it will facilitate the holding of the elections in time. But if any order of the court is going to stop the elections or interfere with the election process, in such a scenario, the courts will never interfere. So our case before the Supreme Court is that one thing is that there is a bar in matters of elections insofar as courts interference is concerned, insofar as municipalities elections are concerned, under Article 243 ZG. This is the first bar. Second bar is that if any dispute is there about elections, there is an election dispute forum created in respect of municipality. It is the district court who decides all the disputes. Thirdly, in our view, the High Court has not considered these issues, and therefore we have challenged the order before the Supreme Court of India, and we are very hopeful that we will succeed before the Supreme Court of India, and this democratic process will be continued and completed at the earliest, so that the people's right and the right of the voters and the right of the public in no manner is affected.
These 2 issues which you mentioned, Ashok Kumar and SR Bommai, did you mention in High Court also?
We have mentioned it in the High Court. High Court has reproduced this judgment in its judgment. Very same judgments and very same portions of the judgments are shown to the Supreme Court today. And after hearing the arguments, Supreme Court has granted this stay. See, the principle is that there are hundreds of cases in respect of elections. Let us say there are 500 parliamentary elections or seats in the country. If somebody imagines that there is something wrong in every matter and everybody files cases in the different courts in the country, the whole elections will be stalled, and that is not permitted by the Constitution. Even in respect of the parliamentary elections or assembly election, there is a complete bar in the Constitution itself under Article 329 of the Constitution that no court shall interfere. Similar bar is there in respect of panchayat election and in respect of municipality election. So we are harping on that point.
So,
that is for the election commission to decide, because now the order of the election commission is stayed, whereby they had kept the process in abeyance. So they have to now act. They will have to take necessary steps which are required to be done. It is their prerogative and their power. They will have to act in accordance with law.
You said that courts cannot interfere. Suppose the party agreed What should we do?
There is a provision in the act itself. Supposing that there was something wrong in the election, then after the election is completed, you file election petition. And in the election petition, we can point out to the court saying that these are the wrong things which have happened. Or even if that is not possible, the party can file a petition in the High Court and say that this election is required to be set aside, okay, because there was something wrong about it or some law was not followed. But that should happen after the election is completed, not before the election is completed. No party is denied of any right to challenge the election. But the point is, at what point of time this challenge can come? This challenge can come only after the conclusion of election. If the court finds, even if the High Court finds that after the election there was something wrong about this election, the High Court will set aside those elections. So that is one thing to say that the court should not interfere in the election process, and it is completely another thing to say that after the elections are completed, the court will not interfere. There is no such a bar. The bar is insofar as the election process is concerned.
बेळगाव सारखी शॉपिंग आता गोयांत शक्य फक्त बॉम्बे बाजारांत. बॉम्बे बाजार घेऊन आयला तरेकवार प्रकारच्यो साड्यो, लग्न समारंभ आणि वेगवेगळ्या सुवाळ्या खातीर खास साड्यो. त्याचबरोबर गिफ्ट करपाक 300 रुपयांच्या साड्यो, सिल्क साडी 900 रुपयांच्या सुरुवात आणि लेहंगा 3000च्या रेंजी पासून सुरुवात. शिलाई आणि एम्ब्रॉयडरीची खास सोय. तर आयजूच भेट द्यात बॉम्बे बाजार, 18 जून रोड, पणजी. प्राचीन आणि कलात्मक वस्तूंचा खजिनो जे तुमच्या घरात घरपण हाडटले. देवी देवतांच्यो मूर्ती असो किंवा पूजेचे सामान, शोपीस असो किंवा तरेकवार प्रकारच्यो शोभेच्यो वस्तू, गिफ्ट करात किंवा स्वतःचे घर सजयात. आमचे डिझायनर शॉल आणि हँडीक्राफ्ट पळोवपाक मुजरत यात. आमचा पत्तो बॉम्बे बाजार, डिपार्टमेंटल स्टोर, 18 जून रोड, पणजी.
Handicraft shopping only at